Today's session 2 will focus on multilateral and regional nuclear dynamics in Europe and Asia. The security environment in both Europe and Asia is becoming more and more unstable and uncertain.
In fact, this is a topic where Japan and Germany have important similarities.
The NPT is completely not just inadequate, but irrelevant as the legal governance structure. By contrast, the Ban Treaty is indeed potentially universal, certainly applies to everyone, and it's non-discriminatory.
As a normative approach, I totally agree with the philosophy of Ban Treaty, but I am not so naive to believe that because of that treaty, we can materialize a world of non-nuclear weapons at all. From a military operator's point of view, nuclear deterrence in particular is becoming much less relevant to national and international security issues.
So I would make the argument that NATO, given its preeminent role, would have the clout and would have the potential to de-emphasize nuclear weapons and to move away from nuclear deterrence and strengthen and develop other forms of deterrence.
From 22nd January, we will have two treaties which should be seen as complementary. And if they're read as incompatible, that will be because those countries that have the bomb refuse to entertain any realistic framework in which to disarm completely.
I would hope that Germany and Japan could lead the change to move away from the adversarial approach currently on display against the TPNW and its supporters. I think we need this discussion about a concrete discussion about the validity of nuclear deterrence in the 21st century.
I believe that eventually we will have to encourage behavioral changes in international relations if we want to make progress on nuclear arsenals, and in particular, nuclear arsenals of the recognized, the formally recognized nuclear powers.